Quarantine has been fun for Prabhavati Surti. She has spent it playing games, attending online classes, and coloring with her 9-year-old granddaughter, Shubhi. And these activities have taken on an added purpose in managing Prabhavati's Alzheimer's. Living with the disease for 9 years has led to memory loss and limited her speech. But engaging with her granddaughter serves as crucial cognitive therapy. Shubhi has grown up understanding her grandmother is different. When she was younger, she was at times frustrated that she was the one looking after Prabhavati instead of the other way around. Now, she talks excitedly about the fun games she dreams up for her grandmother, making lemonade together, giving her a spa experience. Her mother proudly calls her Prabhavati's primary caregiver.
She keeps giving me comments and compliments, and it's really nice to hear from your grandma after a long time. So it's actually pretty good. I think she's fighting the disease and she's trying to get hold of herself and trying to talk to me. She's trying to converse during this lockdown.
But Prabhavati, surrounded by loving family, has been one of the more fortunate patients. Daycare centers like this one, called Hope Ek Asha, were instrumental in providing patient care before the pandemic. Doctors say socialization helps immensely in managing the disease. But now, things look different. Group sessions are no longer held, and all the caregivers wear protective gear and maintain social distance. The change was confusing and isolating for residential patients.
They were used to the caregivers sitting next to them, hugging them, you know, giving them comfort. They were perplexed. What is this? And they were always calling them, come here, come here.
While the residents adjust to their new circumstances, the NGO is also helping patients at home. They have developed a schedule and activity kits with cognitive exercises, which they then help the patients tackle through video calls. Keeping patients engaged helps avert episodes of violence, which can be aggravated by isolation.
Patients had become very aggressive. In the first two, three months, when there was total lockdown, they were not even taken out into the park or even outside. At that time, they had become very aggressive. But after following this routine, the routine we gave them, there's a lot of difference. Now they are not aggressive.
The Surtis have managed to keep any such episodes in check. Shubhi misses her friends at school, but is enjoying the praise and affection she gets for looking after her grandmother. She's certain Prabhavati quietly enjoys it too.